I'm standing at the North Carolina Monument on Seminary Ridge. From this point, General Johnston Pettigrew's brigade of North Carolina troops and other troops launched their portion of the assault on the afternoon of July 3rd. Now, Robert E. Lee still thought that he could win this battle on the morning of July 3rd. Remember, he had defeated a portion of the Union Army in detail on July 1st. On July 2nd, he had not gained what he wanted on Cemetery Ridge, but Lee had accomplished what he considered to be a number of partial successes, most notably the capture of the Peach Orchard along the Emmitsburg Road, which Lee hoped to use as an artillery platform to assault Cemetery Ridge. So the morning of the 3rd, Lee is still feeling pretty good, and he's feeling like he can win this battle. Now, initially in the morning, Lee wants to renew attacks on the Union flanks. Unfortunately, Richard Ewell was engaged over at Culp's Hill attacking the Union right before General James Longstreet was ready to attack the Union left. So Lee realized that he couldn't coordinate attacks on both ends of the Union line. He had to look for a plan B. Plan B is the assault that will happen in the afternoon along the center of the Union line on Cemetery Ridge that we popularly know today as Pickett's Charge.